It's time for the Desert Isle Book Review with Trapper G. Just occurred to me that I should write a jingle for the introduction to this segment. I'm going to review Bob Dylan's new release, The Philosophy of Modern Song is the name of it. Bob Dylan's new book continues in the abstractist tradition of his last book, 2004's so-called autobiography, Chronicles Volume 1. And it will do nothing to diminish Dylan's status as an obfuscating obfuscator. His ineffable Bobness is everywhere. Entitled The Philosophy of Modern Song, the book contains no philosophy and arguably no modern songs. There are 66 essays about some of Dylan's favorite tunes, most of which contain a riff on the song narrator's state of mind, followed by an occasionally relevant discussion of the song itself. Half the songs included were recorded before 1960, and only five of the 66 songs were written after 1980. I guess modern song, in this case, is in the eye of the beholder. The historical breadth of the book is both impressive and head-spinning. A chapter on The Clash's 1979 classic London Calling is sandwiched between Domenico Modugno's Volare and Hank Williams' Your Cheatin' Heart. The physical product is luxurious, with unusually thick paper and generous, albeit unlabeled, photos and graphics. You either recognize Carl Perkins and Little Walter, or you don't. That's the Dylan aesthetic. At least half the time, you have no idea what the hell's going on. You dig it or you don't. Johnny's in the basement mixing up the medicine. One of Dylan's most cogent and on-point essays concerns Nina Simone's Don't Let Me Be Misunderstood. Here's an excerpt from that chapter, followed by the song itself. In 1964, Horace Ott had a fight with his girlfriend and teamed up with fellow songwriters Benny Benjamin and Saul Marcus. They wrote Don't Let Me Be Misunderstood and gave it to Nina Simone. She brought her own artistry to it, and nowadays the static between Horace Ott and his unnamed girlfriend is long forgotten. The song can be sung by anyone who feels they are not getting through to a loved one. But the song has taken on more meanings as Nina's measured defiant delivery has been adopted by some as an understated social equality anthem. Songs can do that. Like any other piece of art, songs are not seeking to be understood. Art can be appreciated or interpreted, but there is seldom anything to understand. Whether it's dogs playing poker or Mona Lisa's smile, you gain nothing from understanding it. Sometimes art can be a blunt fist. The colored rectangles of Mark Rothko, the copious polka dots of Yayoi Kusama, or John Lennon's inexhaustible repetition of the phrase, I want you, in a single song. These are artists so in control of their tools that they know exactly what they are doing. Yet some people rush to judge, brand the work simplistic. Don't let me be misunderstood.
Baby, you understand me now. If sometimes you see that I'm mad, don't you know no one alive can always be an angel? When everything goes wrong, you see some bad. But I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Sometimes, baby, I'm so carefree with a joy that's hard to hide. And then sometimes again it seems that all I have is worry. And then you're bound to see my other side. But I'm just a soul. I'm
and I get more than my share. But that's one thing I never mean to do, 'cause I love you. Oh, 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 baby, I'm just human. Don't you know I have faults like anyone? Sometimes I find myself alone regretting some little foolish thing, some simple thing that I've done. 'Cause I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood. Don't let me be misunderstood. I try so hard, so please don't let me be.
That song aside, Bob Dylan's new book, The Philosophy of Modern Song, has something of a woman deficit, with only 6 of 66 chosen songs written or sung by women. And one of those is freaking Cher's Gypsy Tramps and Thieves. In fact, Dylan seems at times to be messing with the reader, selecting songs that are objectively bad, like Bing Crosby's ridiculous Whiff and Poof song and Johnny Ray's 1951 absurdity The Little White Cloud That Cried. And of all the great Eagles songs, he selects Witchy Woman with those classic lyrics, "Woo-hoo, witchy woman, see how high she flies. Woo-hoo, witchy woman, she got the moon in her eye." Every single song on Hotel California is better than that song. What the hell, Bob? I thought we were friends. I would recommend this book to Bob Dylan fans who appreciate his previous writings and recordings, including his slant and open-ended lyrical excursions and the genius of his satellite radio show, Theme Time Radio Hour. Dylan is a slyly funny guy, and understood correctly, this is a funny and enjoyable book. But you gotta be willing to let Bob be Bob. If not, there's nothing to see here. Move along.